As every year over the last 20 years, you've had an increased budget allocated to health. And every year, without fail, you're going to have situations where hospitals close down, where wards are closed during the summer, where expensive equipment lies idle, where trained people in the medical area have nothing to do because of the situation where hospitals get blocked and people don't get the treatment that they expect or that they deserve. Those who get inside the system will always say, you can't beat at the frontline service and the frontline attention that you get. And I recognise that, as do you. And I know doctors and I know nurses and people in the frontline situations who work exceptionally hard, who are pressurised in very difficult situations, and yet who give over and above commitment to their patients. And that's what we are talking about, patients. Because when somebody gets sick, they want to get better. And they're not really worried so long as that attention can be given to them and that they can be made better and given the best of facilities through which they pay their taxes. In 2008, I set up a commission internally in FineGael to look at the health system and to make a series of recommendations. You're welcome, Joe. To make a series of recommendations as to how we might improve or change the situation for the better. That commission was actually chaired by Alan Jukes, who's now chairing another august body, which is going to contribute tomorrow in part to doubling the national debt, according to what we hear from the Minister for Finance. In any event, Alan Jukes chaired that commission for us, and it came up with the proposition that we should change our health system entirely and bring in what we call universal health insurance, or FairCare is the FineGael name for this, and the emphasis being on fair and the emphasis being on care. Now, I won't take from Dr. James Riley's presentation to you this evening, but I will say this. This is a three-legged stool, and it will not stand without the three legs, and it cannot be introduced overnight, and it won't be introduced overnight. It will be 5 years of the first FineGael back-to-back governments before this actually takes impact and before it's actually seen to be working on the ground in the way that we want it. And to do that, it means you deal with waiting lists. To do that, it means you deal with strong primary care centres around the country. And to do that, it means that you deal then with the patient becoming central to the system, where the patient is seen as an investment and as an opportunity instead of an obstacle. I'll just say this to you. I went to The Hague with James Riley, and we visited a huge hospital over there, 450 beds. There are no trolleys in that hospital. They never heard of MRSA or superbugs or washing your hands every 5 yards. These things don't arise. The longest you'll be in the accident and emergency when you go in there is 10 minutes before a nurse or doctor sees you. And the longest you'll be in that A&E, either to be seen and sent home or seen and admitted, is 2.5 hours. This situation is not theory or not fantasy. It works every day for 17 million people in Holland. 17 million people. They spend less than we do per head on the health system. So if it works in reality and in practice every day, what we want to do is not to translate the Dutch system into Ireland, but to take the best of the Dutch system and translate it into our situation. And we take bits from two other countries as well, which James Riley will explain to you. So what we're saying is that we know that this situation works every day for people in Holland, for 17 million. What we want to do is make it work for the numbers of our 4.2 million who need medical attention every day. Now, 10,000 people marched in Clonmel, 8,000 people marched in Portiuncula, you had big marches here in Sligo, you had marches in Donegal, you had marches in Castlebar, you had marches in Ennis, marches in Bandon and Bantry, and all over the country, people marching about their facilities. What James Riley is charged with is setting out the structure by which we will change the health system for the better. Now, that we'll see to it that we employ more doctors, more nurses, more frontline staff, and he'll point out how we can do that. And at the end of our 5 year period, you're going to have a situation where the people will know that from the youngest baby to the eldest citizen, there is a fair care system in place for everybody. And we will make that work. It works, as I say, every day in reality, not in theory, not fantasy. That's what we want to do. It's a big ask, if you like, to say to people who have gotten so used to a kind of stuttering health service over the years, to say, we can change this completely, take a different direction, make every one of you, in effect, a private patient without privatising the health system. We are guaranteed by the policy set by the Minister for Health, implemented by local trusts and hospitals and the insurance companies to get the best level of attention.